So Phil's got a great profile, okay? Hair, everything is working. I just indiscriminately placed this down. Let's take a picture with it, okay? My guess is that it's gonna need further articulation, but it gives me a quote unquote bad starting point to show a photograph, talk about it, and then we'll move it into the position that I really think it needs to be. Okay. So what I thought would happen actually did happen, which is kind of a cool thing. Light is actually logical and to a degree predictable. What I did when I placed this light, if you can see, the light is fully embracing Phil's profile. So in other words, it's actually slightly forward of him. So that means there's a wash of light that's really flooding all of his face. Shadows. Shadows are your friend. In terms of profile, shadows are important because they define the volume of the face. It becomes a rich and sort of mysterious kind of a feel, you know? There's a drop-off and there's a line of light along the important features. So when I do a profile light, generally speaking, I take the subject's nose right there. That's gonna be 12 o'clock, okay? So let's do this. Phil's pointed this way, all right? There's 12 o'clock. The light can't be at 12 o'clock, nor can it be at 10 o'clock. I really want this light about 2 o'clock. That means it's slightly behind him. That means the light will travel this way, hit his cheek, and die. Because that is where the definition of the profile starts to really be strong. Okay, right now, I'm flooding his face with light. It's too flat. Let's try that. You know, when you start to work on a photograph that you think is going to look really, really nice, it's like you can't wait to get to it. You know, you get kind of, you know, hyper on the set. I do, anyway. Been that way for 30 years. There have been times I thought where I was about to shoot a picture that I wanted so bad that I thought my heart was going to stop while I was shooting. Sounds nuts, but it's true. There's a world of difference here. I don't know if you can see that or not. Vast difference, right, in terms of punch and drama. It's a huge difference in the photograph, but physically, how much effort was made there? I moved the light like 6 inches, okay? Really good telltale kind of lesson in the fact that putting your light where you think you really need to put that light is very important. Sometimes the difference between a good photograph and a beautiful photograph is moving the light a few inches.